If you were alive in the 1980s or 90s, you probably watched the WWF. The WWF were a pop culture juggernaut in the 1980s and 90s and instill a huge sense of nostalgia in millions of people worldwide. Today, let's go over the best way to capture this great enterprise of nostalgia as a graded collectible.
Mad Dogger.
The World Wrestling Federation may be responsible for creating more goosebumps than any other organization during the 1980s and 90s. That's magic right there. And capturing that magic is what collecting is all about. And no other collectible better captures the WWF timeline than the Coliseum videotapes. These tapes have it all. They have every title win, every debut and first appearance, every controversy or special event. It's all here. For instance, right here, Survivor Series 1990 is the first appearance of The Undertaker in his debut.
I give you The Undertaker!
The Undertaker! The mystery partner is now revealed!
I never heard of
him! Oh, take
cow! Right here, Survivor Series 1991, The Undertaker's first heavyweight title win.
Flair with a chair! A steel chair!
And as a collectible, these things have everything you could ask for. The front cover features amazing artwork. It's like a miniature event poster. And the back lists all the matches. It's like a historic record of the event. It's all here. It tells the whole story. Plus, it's so nostalgic. The wrestling section was a significant section in every video store across North America and beyond. This tape has it all, and it perfectly encapsulates this entire event into a graded collectible. And on top of that, the vast majority of these tapes are extremely rare, but you need a little bit of background knowledge to get started. So let's review Coliseum home video factory sealed VHS tapes. The best entry point for most collectors are the pay-per-views. We all have a favorite era, superstar, or event, and they're all here.
I can tell you what the Hulkster's mostly happy about. It's Survivor Series time.
You can cut it with a knife. It's a happening. It's SummerSlam 88.
The Coliseum home video library covers every WWF pay-per-view from the very first one, WrestleMania 1, from March 1985. Through Survivor Series 1997, which kicked off the Attitude Era. Now, once you've picked up a few of these tapes and you've had a chance to admire the beauty, you might get to noticing that there's a catalog number on the side of the box. This is the catalog number assigned to this particular release. And with Coliseum Home Video, you'll definitely want to pay attention to these catalog numbers. The main Coliseum video catalog is referred to as the WF set. The tapes within this catalog run sequentially from number WF001 through WF176. The main WF set contains all the major pay-per-views, as well as compilation tapes and personality tapes. Once you get your fix for the pay-per-view tapes, you're naturally going to want to start looking into the main WF set. So let's take a look. There are four distinct generations of boxes within the main WF set. These are, first, clamshell cases. Secondly, they switched over to slip cases, first generation slip cases. Thirdly, they moved over to big boxes. And lastly, they moved back to their second generation slip boxes. Let's start where it all began, the clamshells. The clamshells ran sequentially from WF001 through WF052. That is with two exceptions, WF45 and WF49. It all started out with four big tapes. Bloopers, Bleeps, and Body Slams, Hulkamania 1, The Best of WWF Volume 1, and the granddaddy of them all, Wrestlemania 1. Now these tapes are a lot of fun. If you get a chance, I highly recommend that you watch some of them. They're a window into that unique era where McMahon was in the midst of the war against the territories to take the WWF national. These guys worked really hard, possibly with more television and live events than any other period. And they had a hell of a time doing it. And you definitely get that feel in these videos. This is a lost era of wrestling, but it is so important. And these Coliseum videos were extremely successful, with Hulkamania selling over 500,000 copies and WrestleMania 1 selling over 1 million copies. The initial plan from Coliseum Video was to release three tapes every 90 days. These tapes included compilation tapes, personality profile tapes, and a novelty series release, plus special events as they came along. There are four clamshell pay-per-view tapes. That is WrestleMania 1, The Wrestling Classic, WrestleMania 2, and WrestleMania 3. There's also the big event from 1986, which technically isn't a pay-per-view, but it was a supercard with a live attendance of over 74,000 people. The clamshell tapes were shipped direct from factory without shrink wrap, and in fact, they were only sticker sealed with an A&H Video sticker seal. A&H Video was the parent company of Coliseum Video and was owned by Arthur Morowitz and Howard Farber. You see, in 1985, just prior to WrestleMania 1, Vince McMahon had just signed an exclusive deal for the WWF home video distribution rights to A&H Home Video, and A&H created Coliseum Video to give their WWF releases some distinct branding. In their first meeting, Vince McMahon was sufficiently impressed with Arthur and Howard, who had been involved in the home video market almost since its inception. Arthur Morowitz is credited with having opened the very first ever video store in New York City in 1979 called Video Shack, and he was also the first ever president of the Video Software Dealers of America, which was the first ever Video Retailers Trade Association. The final clamshell tape is Best of WWF Volume 15. And the following tape after this is WrestleMania 4, which is the only Coliseum tape to be released as a double tape. The next wave of Coliseum video boxes are the first generation slipcases. These slipcases ran from a short window between 1988 and 1989 and are among the rarest of all Coliseum videotapes. Now, when Coliseum Video switched to slipcases, they introduced watermarks. It's worth noting that all my 1988-89 slipcases come with watermarks on the bottoms of the slipcases. It's during this first generation slipcase era that the WWF started expanding its pay-per-view repertoire. And this is where you'll find tapes like the first Survivor Series in 1987, the first SummerSlam in 1988, and the first official Royal Rumble in 1989.
Participating in the Royal Rumble!
These first generation slipcases also have some of the rarest tapes of all in the entire set. These include Demolition, Women of the WWF, Ultimate Warrior, and WrestleFest 1988. Talking with the longtime sealed Coliseum collectors, these tapes likely exist in less than 5 known copies. This generation of tape also saw the completion of the Best of WWF series, with WWF 20 being the final installment in the series. Some debut appearances during this generation are the pay-per-view debut of the Ultimate Warrior at WrestleMania 4, and the pay-per-view debut of Shawn Michaels at Survivor Series 1988. The final slipcase in 1989 was Survivor Series 1989. And then Coliseum Video kicked off the 90s with a bang, introducing the infamous big boxes. I find the Coliseum big box tapes to be so cool. They're the reason I started collecting sealed VHS to begin with. You see, as a small kid, I vividly remember seeing those big box tapes at my local video store at a time when I didn't even watch wrestling. And I was taken aback by how cool the covers were. And when I saw this very copy of Royal Rumble 1991 come up in the previously viewed section at my video store, I had to have it. And only because of the box art. It's that good. Flash forward to 2021, and when a collector showed me a factory sealed copy of the same tape, I was blown away. Because these big box tapes are extremely delicate. Probably the most delicate VHS box ever to be created. It's completely hollow on one side, and also hollow along the top. So for something to exist in mint condition 30 plus years later is something of a miracle, because even the slightest amount of pressure would crease the box. Coliseum used these big box tapes from 1990 through the end of 1992, which covers really the pinnacle of WWF popularity during the golden era. It's worth noting that a few of the compilation tapes from the big box era tend to be the most common Coliseum videotapes. This is because a few dealers found master cases of leftover compilation tapes. Now, I would speculate that this is probably due to the impacts of the WWF steroid investigation, which hit right as WWF was at its pinnacle, and therefore production runs were probably very high at the time, and when there was a sudden downturn in business, it probably led to excess compilation tapes being left unsold. These more plentiful big box compilation tapes, although they're very cheap on eBay, I think it's a great entry point into the Coliseum video collecting realm. I mean, look at this thing. There are some important first appearances and debuts in the big box generation. They are SummerSlam 1990, the true first appearance of the Road Warriors or the Legion of Doom. SummerSlam 1991, the pay-per-view debut of Sid Justice, also known as Psycho Sid. Survivor Series 1991, the pay-per-view debut of Ric Flair. WrestleMania 8, the pay-per-view debut of Papa Shango, aka The Godfather. Another important one is Royal Rumble 1992, which saw Ric Flair's first ever WWF Championship win. Also new in the big box generation, Coliseum Video started including personal gifts wrapped inside the tapes. Can anybody tell me what the heck this thing is? These free gifts include friendship bracelet, pins, a wedding invite window hanger to Macho Man's wedding, and others include patches, luggage tags, bookmarks, whistles, keychains, and posters. And here's a bit of an anomaly. There were three tapes within the big box set which were released as smaller slip boxes as well. It's believed that these are Kmart exclusives. The big boxes are definitely some of the coolest in the series, with the last one being Rampage 92. Coliseum's fourth generation of boxes was introduced right alongside the WWF's rebranding following the steroid controversies. This new era was referred to as the new generation and was a push for a younger, more natural-looking athlete to distance themselves from the steroid look. This led to the rise of many modern-day fan favorites, including Bret Hart, Shawn Michaels, Razor Ramon, Diesel, Lex Luger, Yokozuna, and so on. These second-generation slip boxes ran from 1993 through 1997 and covered catalog numbers WF110 through WF176. Now, this generation is where you're going to find a few gaps in the catalog numbers. There's about 14 catalog numbers that were never used for North American releases. Those catalog numbers either weren't used or they were reserved for United Kingdom Silver Vision releases. There are three waves of box design within these second generation slipcases. These are 1. Holographic top border rip design. Then they switched to holographic belt design, which ran from Royal Rumble 95 to Royal Rumble 96. And lastly, there's the non-holographic belt design. The first release of the second generation slipcases is Survivor Series 1992, which also contains the pay-per-view debut of Yokozuna. And the following tape was Royal Rumble 1993, which contained the pay-per-view debut of Lex Luger. Coliseum Video also rebooted the personality tapes in this era, which took a little bit of a hiatus during the big box era, with the exception of just the Hulkamania series. Now, when Coliseum switched box design to the holographic belt design, this is when they also introduced the free gift with rental program. Coliseum would include with their factory sealed tapes a bundle of promo giveaway items. These giveaways included things like bookmarks, trading cards, pogs, door hangers, stamps, postcards, tattoos, stickers. These promos would come shrink-wrapped together with the Coliseum videotape. There were usually around 40 promo pieces included with the tape, enough for a rental store to give out to all that rented the tape during the promo period. Note how thick some of these things could be. Many of the old-school Coliseum video collectors find these with gift copies to be much more desirable. Now, you might be asking, but you can't grade it with all those gifts in there. Well, it's worth noting that underneath this shrink wrap, the VHS tape is still factory sealed. So technically, if it was separated, it would still be factory sealed. With the introduction of the In Your House pay-per-view series, the WWF essentially moved to monthly pay-per-views. And from here on out, Coliseum Video only had pay-per-view tapes within the main WF set, with one exception. There are some important first appearances within these second generation slipcases. These are SummerSlam 1993, the pay-per-view debut of Diesel. SummerSlam 1995, the pay-per-view debut of Triple H. Royal Rumble 1996, the pay-per-view debut of Stone Cold Steve Austin as the Ringmaster. WrestleMania 12, the debut of Sable and Mark Marrow. King of the Ring 1996, the debut of Mankind. Survivor Series 1996, the debut of The Rock. There were also some important moments during this era, including the birth of Austin 316
says, "I just whipped your ass,"
and Rampage 1997, the first ever Hell in a Cell match. And there you have it. We've covered the main WF set. Now, Coliseum Video also had a few limited run subsets, such as the 500 series, the WW series, the 900 series, and the Collector Series. Now, the 500 series was a series of 10 tapes, and these are considered, even by open box collectors, to be some of the grails and rarest tapes even to find open, and they can go for hundreds of dollars each. Two of the rarest tapes of all are Lumberjacks In Your House, this copy here is sealed, and also Mind Games In Your House, which had a great match between Mankind and Shawn Michaels. Now, these tapes are considered especially rare because they were never available in stores. They were only available by mail order in the WWF magazine. There's also the WW series, which is just a series of three tapes running WW 1901 through 1903. These all have a white rip design border at the top. There's also the Collector series, which is just a set of three tapes right here that run from CS 001 through CS 003. And finally, there's the 900 series of tape, which tend to be a little bit less desirable and more common. And these are more specialty tapes, something like video game tapes or entrance music tapes. And there's a total of 31 tapes in that series. And there you have it. We've covered factory sealed Coliseum Video WWF VHS tapes. Now, there are two more non-WWF Coliseum video tapes, and those are WBF tapes, World Bodybuilding Federation, that is. This was a failed side venture by McMahon during the 1991-1992 era, which happened to launch right before the steroid trial controversies.
The World Bodybuilding Federation shoots off the big cannons for the WWF Championship live tonight, exclusively on pay-per-view. Gary Stridham defends the WWF Championship in a battle of the bulging biceps. But on the front line, the Iron Warrior Mike Christian will challenge along with the flexing Dutchman Barry DeMay, plus a whole rack of 100% U.S.-tested grade-A prime beef.
These tapes are extremely cool, and of course, they're in big box format. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed.